Hello, beautiful Leos. My name is Donna. Welcome to the channel. We have pre-shuffled these cards. We have a four-part reading. It's something new that I'm doing. So time stamped below, after the general reading that I provide, I'm also providing your best course of action, the help and the hindrances that are available to you at this time, as well as what your person likes best about you, Leo. So those are time stamped. So the energy at the bottom of the deck is the Emperor. Beautiful. Aries energy, a fellow fire sign. So in the recent past, you and your partner have been very emotional, very warm, loving, very cuddly, very in one another's emotions and energy. It's a sweet card. It's very nurturing. You're very tuned into each other, very much wanting to mother each other. The Ace of Swords is a current energy, says that both of you have a great deal of clarity about the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth in the relationship. You're both very honest with each other about your emotions, your person, Leo. How they see things proceeding, how they view the relationship currently is kind, loving, loyal, passionate, joyful, passionate desire to grow old with you and to have a future with you. The dog really embodies the deep loyalty that you feel for each other. Look at that. That's a trifecta of beautiful love. The energies, how your person views you. They view you as going through a beautiful transformation. This death card is quite lovely because it speaks to the star within you coming to the forefront. They feel as though you've been through dark night of the soul, you've come out of it, that you're very passionate. You're very much in your heart space with all of this red fiery energy, Leo. But they see the star emerging within you. For many of you, this would indicate or would tell me that your person has witnessed you going through some sort of deep, deep psychological changes, or perhaps even the process of leaving a relationship from the past behind. How do they feel in their heart space? Ooh, they feel that you are pure magic. They are manifesting you. They have all the tools to create this magic with you. The magician is transformative. They transmute energy. And the card of transformation speaks volumes to the fact that your relationship is very likely to be one of long-term commitment. You have this bossing up energy between the two of you in the relationship that says you can handle virtually anything and be successful. How your person sees the path forward with you, loving their best friend, celebrating life with you, spending time in starry nights, enjoying one another, really sharing your emotions, three cups of love, best friends, lovers, nurturing one another. The energy that is hidden is you both have an obsession with each other. That is Capricorn energy. Both of you feel as though you have to have things a very particular way in the relationship. I feel both of you have gone through a period of time in which you've been in very controlling situations, relationships that did not serve you. And when we get this Capricorn energy of the devil, you are very much, if a relationship feels messy or out of control, you would probably leave the relationship. But this is an energy that says you're hypervigilant, you're obsessed with loving each other. Obsession can be good or bad. For the most part, I see this obsession as being very powerful and being certain that you control the idea that the relationship must grow as opposed to fall into disarray. This can be control issues. Both of you may have control issues which you bring to the relationship, which is not unusual, especially for people who are mature, who've had some wounds along the way, shall we say. Spirit is recommending that you keep very logical, very balanced in this relationship. This is all about lock your heart in a cage. You know that you do have to stay very logical and very tuned into the balance and the proper balance in the relationship. I call it the Judge Judy card, looking for the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. And both of you are pretty obsessed with the idea of truth. I really like this this triad goes together quite well. What is the outcome at this time? Okay, well, right now, neither of you are really taking any actions. That is self-imposed limitation, letting the relationship develop on its own to see where it goes. So it's like you're just not going to take anything harshly or to mean anything significant until the relationship has proven itself worthy through time and effort. So let's look and see what the clarifiers are for this reading. I like it. It speaks to people who've been through, you know, some hard times or a more mature outlook on life. Let's see, why is the Emperor card here? We're going to move these out of the way. Okay, the Emperor card. Why is the Emperor? Aries energy is the main energy in this reading. Taking action, fighting for what you want, going after it, not leaving until you get what you want. So both of you have gone through a period of healing, and both of you are in this energy of the Empress, ready to have new growth, ready to fall in love. The planet Venus, the embodiment of everything that's beautiful, that's kind, that's loving. It's also creative ability. The Venus is all about having abundance. It's money, it's love, it's all of the good elements of life. It's the pleasure principle. And so it's critical to the way the two of you are coming together because it's a healthy relationship. Venus in her most perfect embodiment. We have the Empress and the Emperor. You are a divine match. Why do we have the very emotional, beautiful Queen of Cups? Both of you think that the other is a perfect marriage partner, that your belief systems match up, they line up. Your views on things like religion or, you know, cultural beliefs are very much in alignment. You both want to reach the pinnacle of a spiritual success that in which both of you are on the same page. The Magician, both of you are manifesting each other, healing. You happen to be healing each other. Both of you have been through a rough time. And this beautiful, I love this transmutation, taking the negative, turning it into the positive in your relationship. The Ace of Wands is clarifying. The Ace of Swords, you have a passionate desire for truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. I don't think that either of you would tolerate anything less. You both want to speak your truth. You have a lot to say to each other. You have a lot of long talks going on, a lot of really in-depth, spiritual, meaningful discussions going on at this time. The Two of Coins speaks to the fact that it could be juggling too. Now, the card of Two of Coins means that the relationship is not fully committed yet. It shows that your person is very much looking out. Somebody in your person's past wounded them by playing head games and not being honest. So your person is still in this energy of waiting to verify that you are not that energy. They're waiting to verify that. And that's very much devil energy. It's like, okay, the wounds of the past are still with me, and I'm going to control and pay close attention to toxicity. So your person, both you and your person, Leo, are on the lookout for toxic issues you've had in relationships in the past. Why else is the Six of Cups here? You definitely feel the Nine of Swords. So it does speak again to both of you, well, your person especially, having tremendous fear. Because look at that. We have the Four of Swords of healing. We have the Eight of Swords of self-imposed restriction. We have the Five of Swords of having your person having really been treated very badly by someone in the past, someone that they trusted fully. And we see your person is losing sleep about this at night, okay? So it does speak to the fact that there's some real stress here. The Death card. The Death card is clarified by the Hanged Man, looking at things from a different perspective. So your person is watching you to see if you're willing to make another commitment. A lot of people get divorced and they say, I'm never getting married again. And so your person, Leo, is looking at you to see how you're developing, how are you handling the stress of the wounds of the past. They're sort of in this Cirque du Soleil, looking at things from a different perspective, watching you to see what you, how you're transforming your life and what it means to your relationship. We have the Seven of Coins energy. So your person sees, Leo, that you're invested, that you are in it to win it, that you are, you've put some fair amount of effort into this. They feel as though you, oh, perfect energy after the Death card. The Fool card is all about the new beginning, and that is how your person sees you. They perceive you as being someone who is enlightened enough to move forward on your path of healing towards them, but they are very happy to know, Leo, that you are in it to win it with them. We see the Three of Swords card. So for some of you, when I get, and I'm, this is always a combination that I least like, the Two of Coins, the Three of Swords energy. So I would say that for some of you, your person has been through heartbreak that could be separate from you. For many of you though, there will be a fair amount of you that you were in a third party situation, that you met each other maybe through work, through some creative project, but you came together and you were married to other people. And now, you know, they see you, Leo, as being in the relationship with them. Somebody has left a third-party situation. If it applies, remember, this is like a buffet table. Take what's yours, leave the rest, and don't be offended by anything that doesn't belong to you. But the Three of Swords speaks to the fact that your person is excited. They were heartbroken when you were with this other person. The Ten of Swords says that, you know, if you had stayed with that other person, that they would have, you know, they were on the verge of leaving. Now, if that's not part of your reading, then if that's not part of your story, it simply means that your person walked away from another situation. Maybe they were with a spouse that they found themselves wounded and healing from, you know, somebody cheating on them or something along those lines. That's why I think both of you have really been through it because of that double card. Both of you are really not going to be willing to go through double energy or toxicity in this relationship or in any others. The Three of Cups, what do we have here? Honey, I'm home. I love you. Three of Cups, you're my one. That's an engagement indicator also. It can indicate that your person wants to make a very public display of claiming the relationship as being their one and only. I love that energy. It's Cancerian energy. It's Leo energy. All the signs are here. They're very much all present in this reading. So let's see what we have here. We have the Devil energy. Why is it here? Three of Coins. Both of you are obsessed with having a good collaborative relationship. Nobody's in charge. Nobody's in control. Eight of Coins. Learning how to have a healthy relationship. Doing the work day-to-day. Virgo energy. We have the energy of the Tower card reversed. So there was some sort of major transition into this relationship where this came out sideways. There was some sort of, I think, third party situation, because this is a card of having stepped into wanting to win at all costs. The Seven of Swords is, you know, you would cheat to win. Okay, you would cheat to win. So it really says that the two of you have been through it. You never planned it that way. You both fell very much in love. You really didn't know where it would go. But the Seven of Swords says that both of you are very obsessed with being together, making this work, and that both of you are very aware that that was not healthy energy in the past relationship, but the past relationship was also not healthy. So the Queen of Swords, Temperance, beautiful energy. The Temperance card is all about staying balanced. Sagittarius energy. The Queen of Swords is Libra. It rules, co-rules the planets of the law. You know, Libra Queen is where divorce happens. You lock your heart in your cage. The two of you are in this beautiful energy of making things work. The Temperance card. After having been in a very tough situation, after having had to heal a lot of difficulty and wounds, The two of you are very masterfully moving forward in this relationship at an emotional, developmental level. Archangel Raphael is protecting you. The outcome, clarifying the Eight of Swords, is that you're going to stop holding back and you're going to start having fun. The two of you were very limited in the past in terms of the time you could spend together. And it was self-imposed limitation, trying to honor your other commitments. Letting loose, cutting loose, eat, drink, be merry. Your wish fulfillment is here, Leo. It's happiness, it's joy, it's Pisces energy. It's just living in the moment, sensuality, pleasure. Closing out a beautiful cycle of past success and moving into a new cycle of making new choices with your person. The energy of very much of, you know, releasing the past, releasing the toxicity, you know, rebirthing something, that Aries energy. Now we have the Aries Queen, the beginning of a new cycle, very much in that energy of the world release at a crossroads. This is a wonderful reading that shows a lot of growth, a lot of maturity, a lot of awareness of what it takes to make this work, Leo. Great energy for you. So now we're going to look at the Sacred Traveler, and this is going to be all about what is your best course of action. So, best course of action should be the Animal Spirit cards. So your best course of action in this relationship at this time for you, Leo, is the energy of, we will see here, we have Wasp Spirit. Sometimes life stings. So we know from some of our regular viewers that there is an awkward situation for a particular viewer, that they're feeling very much that Wasp Spirit. But it's okay. You know, we get over that. Wombat Spirit, be at home. Be at home in your own skin. You know, let that sting, release it. Nurture yourself at home. And we have overcome any obstacles, Rhino Spirit. So it really speaks to an inner journey of just being at peace with where you're at in your relationship. Now let's see what the Sacred Destiny cards are that will tell us what the helps or hindrances will be in the situation that you're in. What are the helps or the hindrances? Let's see what we have here. We have cleansing waters. Purification activates vibrant life force. So a long hot bath when you're feeling the sting of Wasp Spirit will help you stay grounded, balanced. Also, too, I would say as a couple, it would be very helpful for you to go to a spa or, you know, maybe go to a retreat where there's a nice whirlpool, taking time to relax with each other, staying focused, holding the course, you know, just not letting your doubts or fears seep in, even though it's easy to do that. Just stay the course and embracing enthusiasm. Shout to the heavens with happiness. So be in your beautiful, uplifting spirit, Leo. That's who you are naturally. And, you know, really enjoy yourself. Don't be afraid to laugh. Go ahead, burst forth. Let's look now. We're going to see what your person likes about you best. What does your person like about you best, Leo? What do we have for that energy? What does your person like about you best? Okay, let's see what the bottom says. Awakening. They feel as though you're very aware now in your relationship. They feel like you are woke, baby. You are woke. Okay, so we have Nine of Materials. They love the fact that you are very, you're very good on your own, that you're very independent. Nine of Coins. You don't have to have anybody. You don't have to have a partner. They love the fact that you are making a choice from a very strong place of stability, self-love, beauty, power. They are in awe of you. This is pre-Empress energy, and you are going to Empress energy in this relationship. The Ten of Voices. Your person likes the fact that when you are faced, and the Ten of Swords here, you know, here's your person. it looks as though both of you went through a period of feeling betrayed by the other person. And yet, the Six of Emotions, the Six of Cups is duplicating here. Your person loves the fact that you never stopped loving them, no matter what the trauma, no matter what the drama. They feel very happy and joyful that you could love them after a period of time of likely a breakup. Again, this is a relationship that's been through some things here with that Death card. What else? Ooh, they love Four of Emotions. They love that when you get really upset that you tend to stay very calm. The Four of Emotions is somebody who can balance their cup, that you're stable emotionally, that you don't go off the, you don't, even if you were not happy with what's going on, you don't become unhinged. You stay very grounded. The Knight of Inspiration, the Knight of Wands, they see you as sexy and fiery and hot. They see you as, this is like the proverbial orgasm in the movies, right? It's like they see you with fire in your belly. This Knight of Pentacles is, the Knight of Wands is moving forward very rapidly here. They love to watch you walk or run. There's something about the way that you move, Leo. That is Sagittarius energy. They like the fact that you are very upbeat, very, a lot of fun. The Chariot card, they love the fact that you are, first of all, they probably like the car that you drive, your tasted cars, but they also love your home. They also love the fact that they feel so at home with you, that, you know, they can walk into your space and they just feel welcomed there. It's the Honey, I'm Home card. They also love the Four of Voices. The Four of Voices is that when you get up in your head, you have a tendency to be quiet about it. That you're very much a person who goes within, that you are very introspective at times, that you know how to heal yourself, you know how to take care of yourself. We see it repeated here. And your energy, both of you have that energy of being able to self-heal. The Temperance card, again, they love the fact that you are in the energy. We have Temperance and Temperance. They love the fact that you are calm, cool, collected, that even when things get thorny, that you're very calm, Leo. We see the Page of Cups. Your person loves the fact that you're sweet, you're kind, you're loving. You really offer them many little acts of kindness and love. Cute texts, a sandwich, a note, a cup of coffee in bed maybe. Queen of Emotions, Queen of Cups. Your person loves the fact that you're emotional. And look at how we started the reading with the Queen of Cups, how the reading is ending as the Queen of Cups. The two of you are so emotionally in love that your person is very grateful to that. I do want to look and see what energies could be dark or light. Again, this is the energy of what's happening, what you don't see under the surface right now. What is it that you don't see under the surface? Let's see, we have the Queen of the Day. Okay, Queen of the Day. So both of you are in this beautiful Queen of the Day energy, taking everything a day at a time, feeling as though you're very lucky to be together, feeling as though your relationship has magic, a magical fairy in hand. So there you go. Leo, it's been a joy. Hope you like the reading. Send your love from Chicago. Send some back. Tell me where you're from. And hope to see you in another reading soon. Thank you. Bye-bye.